It takes immense courage and a healthy dose of madness to put an end to what is potentially a financially stable life to pursue your real calling. While following one's passion comes at a high price for a lot of people, for some, all it takes is taking the leap, breaking the clutter, and being a change maker. The Makers brings to you stories of such people from across the country who took the road less traveled. In this episode of The Makers, we have Kai Fernandez, one of the founders of MemeChat, an app that lets you make money by making memes. Welcome to Indian Express. First of all, thank you for speaking with us. Where did the inception of MemeChat actually happen and how did you decipher the concept? If you could just tell us something about it.
I learned how to do computer science. I learned coding. And I built my first social media platform called Subscribe. After I built Subscribe, I started doing coding is not everything to build a good company, right? So I asked my friends to use it. But the thing is, you don't get a very good response when you tell your friends to do it. Right. And then I was like, all right, I need to figure something out. So there was this group on Facebook, a very big group called the Anonymous Group. They had about millions of followers that time. I think they still do have. And they promoted the app. We got about 100,000 users. We almost got into Y Combinator. We pitched to investors. We were very, very, very naive at that moment. And yeah, and then that was working out well. And then it was time for college because 12th was nearing. It was time for college. And it was still not as big as I thought it would be. And me and my co-founder decided, all right, whatever college that we will choose to go into, we'll go in together so that we can continue this entire entrepreneurship journey. And we did. And over there, we realized, all right, now we have to figure out a way that we can promote our company without any investor money. Because investor money was not an option at that time, right? So without investor money, how do we do this? So we created a meme page called Shit Indian Say and the Sarcastic Indian, which now has millions of followers on Facebook and Instagram. And after that, we created multiple meme pages and we partnered on multiple meme pages, like Terribly Dank Tales, Educated Moron, Sarcasm Villa, Confused Atman. And like about now, we have about 250 meme pages with 300 million in following. And after we got these meme pages, initial few meme pages, we started getting brands for marketing. And brands were paying us money for marketing. And we realized that this is a very nice option. We are making memes, we're making jokes, and we're getting paid for it to post on our pages. Then I was like, all right, if people are actually paying for the creativity and the content, why don't I, do something about it? And I was a good programmer. I trained myself to be a good programmer through the years in school and in college. And I created the iOS and Android app, me and my co-founder. He did the Android, I did the iOS, and we made an app called MemeChat. And that's how MemeChat came into being. MemeChat was born because we had the entire distribution channel in place. And then it was easy monetization for us. We monetized the platform well. We started growing in good in numbers. We started creating features. Now, then I went into the subject of AI and machine learning and where I could use that in the app. And now, we're creating like deep fakes, how to deep fake faces into memes and the cool editing tools for, memes and stuff like that. And, because I really like the concept of data and, the kind of data you can extract from, let's say, memes and user behavior and stuff like that, based on, the kind of memes you like. Sometimes you might like, let's say, for example, just to stay out of controversy, let's say Trump and Biden, right? So if you like Trump memes, that means you can infer that, this person is like a sort of right winger. Mm-hmm. And you can see like Biden means you can infer this person is sort of a left winger. And then you get a lot more insight out of, analyzing different types of a person's, liking jokes and the kind of things they laugh at, because, and that is when we realized that, this was a very, very big and a very lucrative option to, to grow a platform. And then we, as entrepreneurs, one, we were good at coding, we're good at programming. So that was a very big plus, for us. And then we were very good at marketing because our marketing game is very strong. We have these pages, we have this massive distribution channel. So whoever would, come to our platform, I mean, it was strong. It was strong in that sense. And that's why, right now we're not growing at full throttle. We're growing at about 5,000 users a day, 4,000 users a day. We are right now almost at 1 million users.
Convincing Indian parents that meme making is something that I want to get into, I'm sure would have been kind of a roadblock. Did it?
It was a massive roadblock. In fact, my now my parents are very supportive because when you earn money from something, then they become supportive, right? But very often I was told, stop building castles in the air. Stop building, things that don't, stop dreaming about, stupid things, focus on your school, get a good degree, get into a good college, get a good job. And that was, that was what they were thinking. And that was too much for them, that, if I could do it or not at that point. And it is a massive roadblock, to convince, my parents. It was that, that making jokes and memes is going to be a lucrative career option. It was unheard of. And because I'm very inspired by like people like Mark Zuckerberg, Elon Musk and stuff and them. And, my thing was always, to be at that, I would love to, somewhere be on that level one fine day. And, it was a lot of convincing, and they only believed once I started earning money. So every decision of yours is going to be stupid unless you can back it up with numbers.
Do you also kind of see yourself in the listicles which say 15 odd jobs or offbeat professions to earn money but also have fun? Do you find yourselves often in those kind of lists? Is that something that inspires you to continue into a profession which is also helping you make money, but it is also something that you know you're good at and people are enjoying and you are enjoying?
So very interestingly that you asked this. So YouTube, you earn money from YouTube, but back in the day, when YouTube started, and it was a growing platform, you would never imagine that you would make a career out of YouTube, and none of the YouTubers also imagined that they'd make a career out of YouTube. But the fact that YouTube grew as a platform that was so big, that is so big right now, because of the number of viewers it has, the YouTubers make a lot more money, right? It is as simple as that. So if a person, let's say right now, is making 1,000, let's say he's making like 3,000 bucks on our platform per month, right? And when the viewers increase, so their earning is dependent on how we grow as a platform. So right now, if we have 1 million users and they're earning 3,000 bucks, once we scale up the users and the creators also scale up in disproportionately lower, then people earn more money. I see this becoming a career option when we have the right amount of viewership.
What is the future hold looks like? The expansion plans? Could you tell me something about that?
The future looks like this, that we need to figure out how we are going to really target memes to users and to the audience and what they like, and we can differentiate as to what they like, show them that piece of content that they want to see, and then put that monetization capability into that piece of content, so that we make money and people make money.
If I ask you to think a little harder on which have been some of the most viral memes created, like the original content created on your platform have been, which ones come to your mind instantly?
So there was a paragliding guy, that Deepak Kalal trend. I don't know if you know about that Deepak Kalal guy. You heard about that?
Yeah.
So we started that one. We started that JCB tractor trend. We started that that bag trend. That school bag trend. That leather bag trend. We started so multiple trends like that we started.
There's a huge opportunity of meme marketing in India. How are you sort of intensifying that for your platform?
I think I think in terms of meme marketing, I think we work with almost most of the meme marketing, the brands who do meme marketing, Alt Balaji, Z5, Amazon Prime, all the OTT platforms, Bollywood movies. I think we have, you know, we do meme marketing for all of them. Then we work with phone companies, OnePlus, Xiaomi, and, you know, multiple other brands, Myntra, about let's say 35 to 40 odd brands.